Today, we're going to be talking about the origin point in Blender, what it can be used for, and how it can speed up your workflow in Blender. First of all, to actually see an origin point, we need an object. So I'm going to press Shift and then A. Then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose Cube. The origin point is just this white dot, or it might be yellow in your case, in the center of our object. If I move my object by pressing G, you will notice how the white dot stays in the center of the object. I like to think of the origin point as almost a reference point for this specific object. In terms of influencing the transforms, which are rotation, location and scale. Mainly rotation and scale are affected by the origin point. To demonstrate this, if I press R to rotate, you'll notice how the object is rotating and it's using that origin point as a reference. The same applies if I press S to scale, you can notice how the object is sizing up and down and it's using that origin point as the reference point. And when I press G to grab and move our object about, the origin will move with our object, but it doesn't really have much of an influence on how it's moved. And that brings us on to how we can actually move our origin. There's a couple of different ways. But the first way I'm going to show you is moving it manually. So I can come up to this options button here in the 3D viewport, and if I left click it, there's an option called Affect Only Origins. If I left click the checkbox, now when I press G, you'll notice that now my origin is moving. So I'll press G and X just to move this along, and I'll maybe pull it all the way to over here. Then I'll left click options again and turn off this option. So yeah, now you can see our origin is all the way out here. And now when I press G, you'll notice nothing will really change when I'm moving my object, but if I rotate it by pressing R, you can see it's using that origin point as a reference to rotate it around. The same will happen as well when I press S to scale, you can see it's going to scale it from that point. I'm going to press Ctrl+Z to undo those changes. Now I'm going to talk about edit mode and object mode and how it affects the origin. Right now we're in object mode, as you can see in the top left hand corner. And when I press G to move my object, you can see the origin point moves with it. However, this is not true in edit mode. If I press Tab, which will allow me to go into edit mode, and I'll press A to select all, and then I'll press G to move all my selected faces, you can notice the point will stay still. And now when I press Tab to come back into object mode, and press R again, you can notice our point has been moved again. But let's say I've completed a bunch of actions, and now I can't undo to get my origin back in the center. How would I go about fixing this? Well, thankfully, it's very easy. With our object selected with left click, I'll then press right click to open up the object menu. And here there's an option called Set Origin. And here we have a few different options for how we can move our origin. Geometry refers to all of the vertices which make up this object. And origin is, of course, the origin point we've been talking about. Let's start off with geometry to origin and origin to geometry. Geometry to origin will move the geometry, or all the vertices, to where the origin is currently set. And it'll move it in a way in which the origin point will end up in the center of the object. I'll press Ctrl+Z to undo that. The other option is to right click and then under Set Origin, we can choose Origin to Geometry. As you might have guessed, that will take that origin point and move it to the center of our object, essentially resetting what we've done. Next up, we have Origin to 3D Cursor. That will move our origin point to this 3D cursor, which is this red and white striped circular cursor thing here. This can be good because we can move the cursor in a few different ways, which will allow us to therefore move the origin in a few different ways as well. Let's talk a little bit about doing that. I'll press Tab to go into edit mode, and I'm going to press 1 on the keyboard, which is going to allow me to go into vertices select. You can also left click it up here, and then I'm going to choose a point where I want to move my 3D cursor to. So I'll left click this point here. Then I can press Shift S, which is going to open up my cursor moving menu. And I can choose cursor to select it. Then when I press Tab to go back into object mode, if I wanted to move my origin to this point, then I could right click Set Origin and choose Origin to 3D Cursor. And now you can see our origin is in that top corner. So when we rotate, it's going to rotate it off that point. And when we scale it, it's going to scale it from that point. The origin is only one of many ways to adjust an object though, as up here in the Transform Pivot Point options, we have a few different ways of choosing how we move objects. For example, if I press G to move this object along and change my pivot point to 3D cursor, when I now press R to rotate, it's going to use the 3D cursor instead of the origin. But this is a topic for another video, so for now, I'm going to change it back to the default, which is medium point, which pretty much just uses the origin in our case. Another thing to know about the origin as well is when I press Alt-G to return the object to the default location, you'll notice that the origin will go to the center of the world. So that is one thing to keep in mind with the origin point in relation to clearing location. But yeah, that just about covers everything you need to know about the origin point in Blender. This video is part of my series on 3D modeling for absolute beginners. And just now we're going through some of the fundamental concepts before we dive into 3D modeling to give you a good foundation for starting. Next time, we're actually going to move on to learning how to use edit mode so we can start modeling some objects. If you want to follow along with this series, make sure to check out the playlist here, which will be having videos updated to it daily at the moment. Also, if you're watching this video later, all the videos may already be out. So it's definitely worth checking out if you like my style of videos and you want to to improve your Blender skill set. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.